Despite all our medical advances, there is still no good man-made substitute for human blood, which is why blood donations are still so important. People donate blood for different reasons. Some do it for friends, family members, or even themselves. Others volunteer to help people they don't even know. During this video presentation, we will walk you through the proper donation steps our donor center here at King Faisal Specialist Hospital and Research Center takes in order to ensure that a reliable source of blood is readily available to whomever needs it. When donors first show up, they have to register at the front desk. The donor must present an acceptable form of identification, which will be kept by the donor room staff until the end of the donation process. The relevant info is then registered in the computer system. Furthermore, positive identification is established by obtaining the donor's biometrical data and a photograph. The information the donor is required to provide is his or her full name, address, and a contact number. At this point, the donor's eligibility and previous donation records are also checked and updated. The donor is then provided with a history questionnaire, customized with his own demographical information, accompanied by the relevant pre-donation educational materials, which must be read prior to filling out the questionnaire. This questionnaire includes queries regarding the donor's health, travel history, medications, and infectious diseases risk factors. Finally, after reading and answering the questionnaire, the donor must sign the written donor consent. The next step would be the donor interview. This discussion takes place in a private setting to maintain donor confidentiality. This interview is performed by a qualified member of the donation room staff who reviews the donor questionnaire and answers any question the donor might have. Another important step to ensure a safe donation is the physical examination. During the examination, the donor's vital signs are measured and recorded. A small sample of blood is taken to determine if the donor is not anemic. All this data is recorded, then stored electronically where it is integrated with the donor's records. If the donor is suitable for donation, a barcode number is generated and the donor is asked to proceed to the next step. If the donor is not eligible to donate for any reason, he or she is asked to refrain from donation, either for a certain period of time or indefinitely depending on the reason the donor was rejected. When the time for the actual blood collection arrives, the donor is called to by name and is required to answer back verbally. The donor's photo is also checked to avoid any discrepancy. Once the donor is properly identified, he or she will be asked to lie down on the donation chair. The arm is then cleaned thoroughly with an antiseptic. A new disposable collection set will be labeled with the barcode number generated earlier and used for that specific donor. The whole blood drawing process takes all of 10 minutes approximately. Normally, the blood drawing process has no adverse effects, but sometimes an unpleasant reaction may occur. Symptoms of such a reaction might include weakness, sweating, and dizziness. But the donor mustn't worry, for the donor room staff are highly trained to handle these rare occurrences. After the blood unit is collected, the donor is given post-donation educational material. Once read, the donor then must sign that he or she received said materials before enjoying the complimentary refreshments. The donor is also asked not to leave the center until cleared by one of the donor room staff. The donor can always withdraw himself from the donation process before, during, or after the actual blood collection without any justification if he thinks his life is at risk or his blood is not suitable for transfusions. You may wonder what happens to the blood after donation. The blood is processed into different components and quarantined until the proper testing has taken place. This testing includes HIV, hepatitis B virus, hepatitis C virus, malaria, and other infectious agents. If cleared, the blood is taken out of quarantine and labeled with the donor's blood group for subsequent transfusion. The donor is always encouraged to speak to the donor center medical professionals if he or she may have any questions or concerns about giving blood. If after giving blood, the donor becomes aware of any information about his or her health that would affect whether or not we should transfuse the donated blood to patients, he or she must call the donor center immediately.